Okay, so now that we have our clay ready, and we did wedge this little guy, and we told this ball of clay he's going to be a cylinder. He will sit at the wheel, and again, make sure you're comfortable. Make sure you feel at the right height, that you're at the place where if your elbows are on your knees, your hands meet in the middle of the wheel. And we're going to put the clay on the wheel. Before we do that, I like to, I call, slap it round. Just the more rounding it is now, the less you have, less centering you do later. So again, you put it on the wheel with a bit of attitude. This is your clay, your wheel, your pot, and put it down with some attitude. So now it's stuck to the wheel, and you're going to want to center it. You can see it's not in the middle of the wheel. Your left hand goes at a comfortable place on the clay, cutting it in half. Your elbow is wherever it feels right on your leg. If it doesn't feel right, it's not. So your left hand is cutting the clay in half, and it pushes the clay up, and your right hand is pushing it in, cutting it in half, pushing it down. When you're first starting on the wheel, you want to start off with a handful of clay. You want it to feel comfortable in the palm of your hand, not too big, not too small, just right. And so the clay is going to be pushed up by your left hand with all the pressures in the middle. And you're going to push up with the palm or the heel of your hand, kind of extension of the bone there. And it just is attached to your knee, and it cuts the clay in half and pushes it up. Your right hand is going to push the clay down again, wherever it feels comfortable on your leg. But the pressure of your right hand comes from this fat thing below your little finger, and it cuts it in half and pushes it down. And it's that up and down motion with pushing up in the middle and down the middle. The clay has nowhere else to go but the center. So up and down, and make sure your clay doesn't dry out. You don't want little dry bits that'll be tugging and pushing on your hand. If it is centered, as soon as it dries out and pulls on your hand, it's not centered anymore. So up and down. And don't be afraid to move it a lot. Make sure you get some movement in your clay. Okay, now if you're not sure it's centered, because when you first start potting it, it feels centered, but it still has what I like to call rhythm. It's still kind of doing this. So you want to touch the outside of the wheel head because you know the outside of the wheel head is centered, it's smooth, it's round. And if you close your eyes and feel the wheel head, the nice centered feeling, keeping your eyes closed, bring them in to the clay in the middle, and if there's any rhythms there, your hands will be more attuned to them. This feels pretty centered, so I'll just give it a few more pushes up and down. Okay, now it's centered, but don't be worried about how much water you're using. When you first start on the wheel, you're worried about, should I be going this fast? Where's my hand? Where's my knee supposed to be? My elbows are, and then you have all this stuff you're supposed to be worrying about. The one thing that doesn't matter is how much water you use. I don't use a splash pan, mainly because it's easier here for you to see. And two, at the studio, I don't use a splash pan because I make big stuff and it doesn't fit inside. So as you get more adept at potting and more practice, you'll get drier. But meanwhile, just let the mud fly. That's why we're here. And it just have fun with it. Don't worry about it. And if you're lucky, someone will clean your mess. And if you're not, all you have to do is clean up some mud. So anyway, don't worry about the mud. So now we're going to open it. It's centered. Your left hand stays just where it was when it was centering, and your right hand goes from cutting it in half to opening. Now I'm going to hang on to the back of my left hand. Always join your hands if you can. Keep your elbows on your knees and your hands joined at all times. It gives you kind of a triangle of strength and keeps you in control and not the clay. So your left hand stays where it was. You hang on to your left hand with your right, and you're going to go down with the middle of your, with the, your middle finger. I like to support it with my index finger and sometimes even my fourth finger, and it goes down at a 45-degree angle. And it's hanging on, I'm on my knees, I'm strong. And you want to make sure, because as you're going down into your clay, you could go right down to the wheel head and make a planter. We're not making planters, we're making cylinders. So you want to make sure you don't do that. As you pot, you will get a feeling, and you'll just know as you've made a lot of pots how far the wheel head is from your finger. But until then, make it a practice to check it. take your needle, it doesn't matter which one, and I'm just going to do is poke it down until it touches the wheel head, and then run my finger to where the bottom of my pot ends and measure it. And you want a little less than a half, whatever that is, a half of an inch or less. And pottery pots, it's best to err on the side of thick than thin. It's better to have a little bit of thick bottom than a thin bottom. Anyway, so now we've got it open to where we want it. And all I'm going to do is pull my middle fingers to the palm of my left hand. And then one motion that goes to the palm of my hand. And then my left and right hand go up together in a cone shaped cylinder. And that keeps it in control. The wheel wants to make bowls, and bowls are great. The centrifugal force, you'd make a bowl every time if you don't keep it in check. So make sure your cylinder is either straight up and down or slightly cone-shaped, and you won't get the bowl happening. So again, make sure all your surfaces are wet. If there's any pulling or tugging, add water. You go across, and then your left and right hand go up together, not letting the top get too thin. If it gets thin, just compact it with your finger and thicken it up. Again, in pots, a little bit thicker is always better than a little bit thinner. Okay, now I'm going to pull my middle finger of my left hand across the bottom. It's going on the inside. And it's going to go across and pull the walls up. So at this point, my middle finger is still going across the bottom. And my outside finger is quite a bit higher. And you can see that ridge of clay that I'm pulling up. What's happening is the walls are getting taller and thinner. And I always, before I do a pull, make sure the inside is wet and the outside is wet. They're going to go across. And what I'm going to do, at this stage, you can see the ridge that I was pulling up. I'm going to cut it in half and open it up so you can see just what it is my hands are doing. On the inside, my left hand is below my right hand. My right hand's quite a bit higher. And as my fingers move up the wall, my fingers get closer together. And as they get closer together, the pressure decreases until they come near the top, and the pressure basically stops. There's just a follow-through motion. And then I run my finger along the top of it just to keep it in check. You don't want the top getting too thin. So now we'll make another cylinder, and we'll quickly review just what I said. And what I'll do is I'll let the top get too thin so you can see what I mean, and then I'll thicken it up to show you how I think it should be. Okay, so again, with attitude in the middle. Before you put your clay on, you want to make sure, you noticed I cleaned the wheel head off. You have to make sure that all the clay is off the wheel, otherwise it won't stick. It can be wet, but it can't have any clay on it or your little ball won't stick at all. So your left hand is now pushing the clay up. Your right hand is pushing the clay down. It's that up and down motion. You have to make sure you're right in the middle, because if you're off to one side, a third or two-thirds, you're going to spend more time pushing it off-center than on-center. Again, if both pressures are right in the middle, it has nowhere to go but center. So now we're going to open with our right hand. The left hand stays where it was when it was centering. The right hand hangs onto the back of the left, going down at a 45 degree angle, being careful not to go all the way down to the bottom, to the wheel head. Then pulling your fingers across the palm of your left hand, left and right hand going up, and then controlling the top. Now your left hand goes on the inside, your right hand goes on the outside. You make sure that all your surfaces are moist, and you pull that layer of clay up. Now I said before, as you start to get to the top of the clay, you decrease your pressure. If you don't, the top just gets thinner and thinner. And it just doesn't look good. It reminds me of, I call a bad movie, where it just sort of runs out of tape. It just has this wishy-washy, nondescript ending. A thin top on the pot has the same. So we're going to go up, and we're just going to let it get thinner and thinner. And it just doesn't, not allowing it to See, it caught my finger there and it knocked it off center. Got dry. You see, it just sort of comes up. It's uneven. It's too thin. If you turn this upside down, it's not going to be level. And it has to be level because we're going to trim it later. And it probably wouldn't even support the weight, that thin ridge. It also, it just doesn't look nice. So we mentioned the two needles at the beginning. This is the thin needle with the wooden handle that's quite sharp and flexible. I'm going to hold it like a pen. And my elbow is on my knee. I'm sort of leaning my shoulder in for support. I can't put this elbow on my left leg, so I'm going to tuck it into my rib cage and then join my hands. Again, join your hands anytime you can. Then I'm just going to slowly apply the needle to the clay, to the pot, and I'm going to poke through, letting the pot spin many times before I make it all the way through. People quite often jump at that and they go in too fast and it knocks it off center. So just let it go around a bunch of times, cutting a little bit as it goes through. And then when you reach your finger, quit pushing on the needle, and you'll cut the top off. So now you've got a little bit more clay there. And while this is just a basic little cylinder, it still should look good. So I'm going to make sure this guy has some straight sides and then a finish on the top. So he's going to come up, have strong, straight walls. And then I like it to just bend out a little bit. All I'm doing is bending slightly this piece over my one finger, over the top of the other finger. Going to sponge off any sharp edges. And it just has more of a finish. It comes up and says, I'm done. I'm a little cylinder. So now we also want to trim this tidy at the bottom when it's leather hard, when it dries some. But I'm going to cut off some extra before that, because what you can cut now will save you a lot of time later. So all I'm going to do is follow the line of the cylinder wall with the firmer needle. This is the metal needle with a stronger and duller needle shaft, but it stands up to this better. And all I'm going to do is, again, letting the wheel spin many times around before it gets to the bottom. Don't go jabbing it right in there. So go down and then undercut it. And sometimes, everyone who's tried to make a pot has found this, that if you try to cut this off, half the time it doesn't come and it comes off in little sections. What you're doing is when you're going down, you're not going down straight as you're going back a little bit and you're having a whole bunch of little pieces to cut off. So if you don't want it to do that, just take your sponge and put a little drop of water in that trough that you made. And then just run that water around with the needle. And then if you cut it off, it'll come off in one clean, soft piece. So now I'm going to clean up the inside. There's a little bit of water in the bottom of the cylinder. And if I leave water in the cylinder, it's going to eat the bottom out. If I leave it overnight, I'll come back and it'll be all cracked and it'll wreck your pot. So just take your sponge and clean the water out. And make sure there's no gobs of clay on the outside. Sponge off any fingerprints. Do as much finishing now as you can so you don't have to do it later. Now we take one of the boards that we had at the beginning, and I'm going to take the pot off the wheel, put it on the board. So I'm just going to take a little bit of water and put it in front of the pot and behind the pot. And with the wire, I'm going to cut it, and it's going to do two things. It's going to cut the pot away from the wheel head, and it's going to drag a layer of water under the pot, and I'll be able to take it off. If it doesn't come off with just the slightest amount of pressure, and you've got it this far, don't stick your fingers in it now, so just do it again. You don't have to spin the wheel. Just pull that water under there, and then now to slide it off gently onto your fingers. Okay, we made a cylinder and we cut it in half halfway through the process, showing you what it was like as the fingers moved up and the clay got thinner and the walls got taller. We also made a cylinder we like to get too thin at the top, and then we cut it short, making a finished short cylinder. What I'd like to do with this one is we made it is to cut it in half to show you what a finished cylinder should look like. Now this guy has even walls. It has a little from the bottom to the top. It has a little bit of thickness right in here. And when I turn it upside down and trim it, this is going to go away in the trimming. And so when it's a finished cylinder, you can see that this wall is even from top to bottom. taking in account the little bit of trimming that we're going to do at the end. So that's what you want to make sure you have, is even walls. It doesn't necessarily have to be that thin. I don't worry about a thin wall. Even is the first place to start. Thin is not always better. You want a thick, secure wall that will stand up and be a pot. What I'll do is we'll make another cylinder, and I'll make it a little taller and thinner. It'll be a vase. A vase is just a cylinder with a little bit of shape, little shoulders, a little cuddling in. So we'll talk about some shaping, and we'll come back and make a vase.